It's so nice to be able to talk with you again. Talking is pretty important, isn't it?
I agree, especially because of what happened to me once. Hey, Teddy, why don't you tell everyone about that,
All right, Grubby. That's a good idea.
Thanks. You know, even though something kind of bad happened to me, it ended up okay. Remember?
I sure do, Grubby. It was a beautiful day. Aunt Newton Gimmick had invited Grubby and me to join him on a nature hike in the forest. Gimmick told us the names of all the different plants we passed along the way.
This delicate foliage is Stepticoniconi pigmatoliosis. Its crimson leaves produce a most effective red dye.
It looks just like the red in your tablecloth.
Very observant, Teddy. I use the leaves of this plant to color the tablecloth.
Gee, that's fascinating, Gimmick.
Yes, it is.
Oh, and here's some aromatic Tastioni zestofini.
Zesta, hoochie, tootsie, fruitsie?
Tastioni zestofini. It's an herb, a spice. I add it to all my soup broths.
Oh boy, I love your soups, Gimmick. And just saying, toasty, mosty, zippy, doo-dah makes my mouth water.
Well, it's lucky that we came this way, because we're low on tasty, soup weed. Would you fellas help me pick some?
Of course, Gimmick.
I'll tell you one thing. Talking about plants is sure a lot harder than eating them.
While we were picking the soup weed, I noticed a most unusual-looking plant right next to it. What is this plant?
Oh, I'm so glad you asked me about it, because this is a strange plant with a pretty strange name. The shush bush.
The shush bush?
Shush bush? Well, it sure does taste good.
Oh, no, Grubby. Don't eat that.
Gimmick, what's wrong?
Oh, I didn't have the chance to explain. The shush bush is called the shush bush because it has been known to cause a temporary paralysis of the larynx mechanism.
What does that mean?
It means Grubby could lose his voice.
That's silly. These cute little shush berries are too good tasting to be bad for you. In fact, I feel better than I did now.
What did you say, Grubby?
You see? It's working. Or it's not working. I mean, the plant's working and Grubby's voice is not.
Are you sure? Grubby, say something. You're right, Gimmick. Grubby's lost his voice. Look, Gimmick. Grubby's trying to tell us something. Grubby was moving his arms about, first one way, then the other. We tried hard to figure out what he was trying to say, but we couldn't understand.
You want to play an accordion?
You're thirsty, and you want a bucket of water?
No, I got it. You want to play grunge ball?
I don't think that's what he means, Gimmick. I know. Gimmick, do you have a pencil with you?
Of course.
And some paper?
I always do.
Okay, that's great. Grubby, you can write down what you're trying to tell us. Here, Grubby. H-O-W-L-O-N-G. How long?
How long is the accordion?
I don't think so, Gimmick. I think Grubby wants to know how long this will last.
Oh, it's been known to last anywhere from 1 hour to 10 years.
Grubby started running around in circles and waving his arms about every which way. Then he calmed down. Grubby didn't have to write down what he was trying to say this time. We could see that he was pretty upset. I know it'll be hard to write all the time, Grubby, but it seems the best way to understand you. Oh, look! There's Leota.
Hi, Phyllis. How are you today?
Oh, Leota. Grubby ate some of that shush bush over there.
Oh, my!
And now he can't talk.
Oh, Grubby. I hope you learned that you shouldn't eat things if you don't know what they are.
Grubby nodded his head up and down to say yes.
Now you're trying to figure out a way to talk with your friends, right?
Yes, Leota. We figured out that Grubby could write down what he wants to say to us. Right, Grubby? See, Leota?
Yes, and writing things down is a very good idea. But I have an even better way for Grubby to talk with you.
How?
With his hands.
With his hands?
Sure. It's called sign language. It's the language that deaf people use to talk. You see, deaf people have problems hearing. And sometimes when they speak, they don't sound the way we do. So deaf people use their hands to talk.
Oh, you mean when I point my finger at something I want or wave hello to Grubby, I'm using sign language?
Well, not exactly, Timmy. You're talking about gestures, and using gestures is one very good way to talk without using your voice. But sign language is different. It's a real language. Anything you want to say out loud, you can say. Sometimes even more beautiful, with your hands.
That sounds great, Leota. How does it work?
Like this. Place one of your hands on top of the other hand, palms touching.
Okay, got it. Grubby does too.
Now slide the top hand all the way across.
Like this?
Yes, that's right. You just made the sign for nice.
I did?
Nice. Hey, this is fun.
Really cool.
Now, point both index fingers straight up in the air and let your hands bump. You just signed meat.
Meat. This is great.
Uh-huh. Now, to say you, just point to another person.
Oh, this one's easy.
You.
Now put them all together, and we can say and sign, it's nice to meet you.
It's nice to meet you.
Very good. You got it. Now follow me. It's nice to meet you.
It's nice to meet you.
It's a beautiful day.
It's a beautiful day. It's nice to meet you.
Come on and play.
Come on and play.
It's nice to meet you.
It's nice to meet you.
I'm feeling fine.
I'm feeling fine.
It's nice to meet you.
It's nice to meet you.
I'm glad you are a friend of mine.
I'm glad you are a friend of mine.
It's nice.
nice to meet you.
I'm feeling fine.
I'm feeling fine.
It's nice to meet you.
It's nice to meet you.
I'm glad you are a friend of mine.
I'm glad you are a friend of mine.
Would you like to introduce yourselves to the class?
Well, Grubby quickly began fingerspelling our names and then told them our name signs. The students were really surprised. They started introducing themselves to us in sign language until finally we met Katie. Gimmick signed,
"Very pleased to know you, Katie."
And I signed, "It's nice to meet you, Katie." And Grubby signed, "I'm glad to meet you, Katie." Then Katie signed to us, "It's nice to meet you, too." Wow, you sign very well.
Thank you.
Yes, thank you, Katie.
Yeah, it's lots of fun.
Grubby, you got your voice back.
I did? Testing, 1, 2, 3. Hey, Teddy, you're right, I did. But you know, even though I lost my voice, I never stopped talking.
Remember, sign language is just one way to talk without saying a word.
Yeah, you're right, Miona. Why, you can also say, "It's nice to meet you," by just shaking someone's hand.
Uh-huh. Or when you pat me on the back when I'm feeling bad, Teddy, that always makes me feel better.
Grubby. You know, a pat on the back, a handshake, or even a smile are ways in which we can all talk without saying anything. They're all special signs of a friend. There are some signs that we all understand. I know what it means when you're holding my hand. The way that I smile when I see you again. These are the many signs of a friend.
There is a sign that to say hi. It's the same sign that I use for goodbye. I wink my eye when I wanna pretend. These are the many signs of a friend. The sign of a friend doesn't have to be heard. You can say friend without saying a word.
Lock fingers together with some of your friends and make a circle that never ends. There are some signs that are a must.
Signs of affection, of friendship and trust. If you need a sign, I have one to lend. There are so many signs of a friend.